If you are a teacher or a tutor, this video is for you. In this video, you will learn how to use a learning management system called Canvas to build your online courses. So let's get started. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir Yaqub and I teach online. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any videos. I make videos about technology tools and productivity tools, some of the subjects which I teach, and how to videos about creating online courses. And this video is one of those videos. So if you are interested in one of these topics, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any videos. So this video is a short tour about a learning management system called Canvas, which is one of the leading learning management systems in the world. You can use this system to create your online courses. You can put your video lectures online, lectures from other teachers. For example, you can put YouTube videos in Canvas and then you can create some courses. So this is called the content curation, because you are putting together contents from different resources. You can also upload quizzes and assignments, and then students can come and they can do those assignments. You can also create some quiz banks in your subject area. So Canvas provides you a wonderful platform to create all these courses, and then these courses will be a source of income for you. So this video is a short tour of Canvas. I will jump on my computer and I will show you what are some of the basic features of Canvas. So let's get started. So now we will see a brief introduction to Canvas, one of the world's best learning management systems. And I am logging into my free account, and this is my dashboard. On the left hand side I have courses, calendar, inbox and commons, and these are my two courses. Let's click on this course and I'll show you some of the features. On the left hand side I have all the teacher tools available: assignments, discussion, grades, people, all these things. First see this main page of the course. So this is course name. You can edit anything. So this is a module based course. There are three modules in this. So the advantage of module based courses is that you can set a condition that students must complete module 1 before they could be able to enroll in module 2. So these type of things, if you want to impose any conditions. Or otherwise it's easy to manage. So I have three modules in my this demo course. The best thing which I like about this learning management system is that you can create quiz banks, and you can put all your questions in your quiz banks. So all your assessment process will become very easy because all your questions are there, and then you can select all the questions in your quizzes. So let's see how it works. So let's click on this quizzes. And as you can see that there are three dots here. I can add a quiz here. Currently I have these three quizzes. If you click on this dot, you can see that there is a icon manage question banks. If I click on this, you can see that I have these three or four question banks. There is no question in this bank, but there are two questions in this bank, 12 questions and 10 questions. So I have put my questions in this bank, these banks. So these are my questions in my fraction bank. So let's say I want to create a new quiz. So then what I will do, I will take some questions from this bank and I can add into my quiz. So in order to do that, you simply go to quizzes, and then let's say I want to add the question into this one. So I will edit this quiz. So I can add some details about this quiz here, whether I want to shuffle the answers, time limit, whether the students are allowed to see the incorrect answers. I can tick this and then here you can see that these are the details of this quiz, but there is another icon questions. And if I click on questions, and then I can find questions in my banks. So if I click on find questions, so these are my question banks. So let us say I want to add questions from fraction bank. So I click on fraction and I want to add these two questions. So just click on these questions, and then at the end you just say add questions, and these questions have been added into my quiz. And then if I like, I can just save this quiz, and it's so easy. So once your questions are in your question banks, then everything essentially runs on auto. Whenever you have to take an assessment, it will take you just 5 minutes. You just arrange all the questions from every bank.
if you want, are from one particular bank, and then set everything on auto. Student will see the results, you will see the grading, all the reports will be ready. So it's so easy and so fascinating that you can take courses of hundreds of students with a very little effort. And you can also create some conferences if you want. It's a conference, and then on the right hand side you can create a conference here. You can mark any attendance. You can make any attendance compulsory for any type of calendar event. So you can take attendance, anything you want. So all the features are available in this. So it's a very good learning management system. It gives you a lot of functionalities. So let's say have a look at modules. In here I have three modules. You can add another module. Let's click on this first module. If I click on this, this will take us to the main page, and here, as you can see, that I have curated some contents. This is not my own video. I have inserted some YouTube video here. So you don't have to reinvent the wheel. If somebody else has prepared a good topic or a good lecture, you can just put their video. You can just embed their YouTube video in here. Now, in this setting panel, you can change the setting of your course. For example, if you want to delete the course, you have the option to delete the course. You can set the start date, finish date, and all sort of options are available. So later on, I will definitely make a separate class, maybe 1 hour class on this Canvas. So this was just a brief introduction to show you that what these LMS look like and what kind of functions are available in these LMS and how these can be used to create online courses. So I hope that you find this useful.
So I hope that you find this video useful. If so, please hit the like button. Thanks for watching. See you next time.